Hi, and welcome to another episode of our ongoing series, How to Make a Game in Unity. This is brought to you by Straight Up Tech. Let's learn together. So in today's episode, what we are going to do is, now we are going to actually pick up these collectibles. If you would have remembered, we have made collectible items in our last episodes. If you don't remember, then I will link the episode above. So now we want to pick up our collectible object when our player collides with them. Right now, if you play the game, then and you grow closer to these collectible object, nothing will happen. See, the player just collides with them and goes back, because we have not yet told the program what to do if the player collides with the collectible items. So to achieve what we want to do with the collectible object, we actually need to detect the collision between the player game object and our collectible game object. To do that, we will trigger a new behavior whenever our player object collides with our collectible objects. But there is a problem which we will face when we try to collide with any other object. That is, our plane, player, walls, collectible all have collider components that inform us of collisions. So if we didn't test our collisions to know which game objects our player is colliding with, we will end up collecting a wrong object. That means we can accidentally collect and trigger a behavior with essentially any game object in our game scene. So to make our game seamlessly work, we have to make changes to our game controller script and test actually what our player is colliding with. So we'll open our player movement script. In our player controller script, we'll test for collisions. But for now, back to our game scene. Here you will see that we have 6 collectible objects with us. Now we cannot go and code for each and every collectible object, and as we want to achieve the same thing with every collectible object, we will use the tag function which is already there in Unity. Now to use that, what we'll do is we will set our prefab collectible, open the prefab, and in the tag we will use add tag. You will see that list is empty as of now. So you will write a new tag and name it as collectible. Save. We will go back. So collectible, open prefab, and now you will see the collectible tag is being shown in the list. We will select that tab and save. Now since we have made a change to the prefab of the game object, we will see that all the game object of collectible have the same tag. This way makes it easy for us to program the collectible just once, and we can use the same function again and again for all the collectibles. Now back to our program. Now to trigger an on collider event, we will program it like void on trigger enter collider. Now you see this collider function is already added. So what this will do is, we don't want it to be private. So now what this will do is, this will access the collider component of our player, and now we can check what that collider component has actually collided with. For that we'll write an if condition, other dot game object dot compare tag. Because we have tagged our game object as collectibles, we will write inside this collectible. That what we want to do is, if our player collides with a game object which has a tag correctable, we want to deactivate it. So to do that, we other dot game object dot set active and false. Now this will just deactivate our game object, so it will be removed from our scene and it will look like that our player has corrected that game object. We will save our script. Just go back and see we have written the tag right. So now when we press play and move our player, we collide with this, it is still not picking up the game object. This is because we have not done a very important thing which we need to do to use the trigger function. Now to do that, we will again set up prefab, open the prefab, go to our box collider, and we want to enable this is trigger function so that the trigger is enabled. We will again save it, and now when you press play and move our player, see the trigger function is working very smoothly and it looks like that player is picking up these objects. Now we can achieve many things with this function, like we can break the object, we can remove the object, we can do many sorts of things with the player movement, in which way the player will react while touching the other game object. So I hope you will try all of these. This is all for today's episode. In the next episode, we will learn how to use the score text. We will develop some enemies and the game over screen. So thank you for watching. Do subscribe and click on the bell icon so you never miss our video again. Have a nice day.